Schema, what is schema? It is a logical structure of the database. It is a logical structure of the database. You prepare your ER diagram, or you can see you prepare a blueprint before actually designing the database. That thing is called as logical thinking of your database is called as schema. Then what are different types of schemas available in databases? There are two types of schemas available. One is called physical schema and another is called logical schema. As we have studied in the previous this diagram, logical and physical level, right? So you can relate that schemas to logical level and physical level here. What is physical schema? Database designing at physical level. Database designing at physical level is called as physical schema. So what happens actually at physical level and what physical schema means is how many tables should be there, how much size each table is going to take, total size required by your database will be decided by database administrator, and he will create a space for that database. Physical level always deals with the size of the database. Okay, deals with number of tables in the database and their sizes. Check this. So what is physical schema? It is very simple. Database design at physical level is called physical schema. And what we decide here, what we design here, the size of the database, total size is required, enough size will allocate actually. If your database administrator will allocate 10 terabytes of data size for suppose XYZ database, like college database, hospital database, you allocate sufficient size for storing the data. Then you decide how many tables should be there, what should be the structure for it, right? For storing the data, what type of data should be stored into it, that will be decided at another level, that is called as logical. Whenever the concept of linking the database comes, we always look for logical schema. So what is logical schema? Now the physical schema is done. Your database size has been decided, the spaces have been allocated, then you created the tables. Now logical schema comes into the picture, where what is logical schema? Database design at logical level is called logical schema. What we do at logical level? We actually check how many tables are there and what should be the relationship between each and every table with the help of primary key, foreign key, and other types of keys. We can relate. We are able to relate this all tables. That logical thinking happens at logical schema. You can see in logical level what we're saying. Logical level describes the data stored in the database and the relationship among the data. So what is happening here in logical schema? The tables are there already created. You are linking those tables with the help of primary key and foreign key. That type of designing is called as logical schema. Database design at logical level is called logical schema. Now coming to the another definition called as instances. What is the instance of a class, students? Can you tell me now? Suppose this class is happening live. What is the instance of this class just by seeing the screen? You might have studied in object-oriented programming languages like Java, C++. What is the instance of a class? The number of students actually attending the class now. Here I can see it is 96, correct? So the number of people who are attending the class is the instance of the class, correct? If suppose 4 students left this meeting, then what would be the instance of the class? It will be 91. Actual data stored in the database is called instance. Say, take an example of a variable, integer a equal to 5. What is the instance of variable a? Now it is 5, correct? If I change the value of variable a from 5 to 10, what will happen? The instance becomes 10, recent value, correct? Your database gets updated every day. So the instance changes. The actual data stored in the database is present at a particular moment is called instance. The actual content of the database at a particular point of time is called as instance. You can relate it with the variable value in programming language. Instance is similar to that. Then coming to the important definition, and then we'll finish our today's session. One is physical data independence and logical data independence. This question was asked for 2 marks. Okay. Now you can see this previous diagram. There are two levels, important levels, logical level and physical level. This is logical level, bottom level is physical level. Now what do you mean by this? Physical data independence. It is the ability to modify physical schema. Please consider on this point, students. It is the ability to modify physical schema without disturbing higher levels like logical level. You are able to modify physical schema without disturbing other levels is called physical data independence. Correct. Independence stands for freedom to do anything. So what is physical data independence? It is the ability to modify physical schema without disturbing other higher levels is called as physical data independence. Now we'll move to another definition called as logical data independence. What is logical data independence? You are able to modify. It is the ability to modify a logical schema without disturbing other levels of it, data abstraction. Then we can say that it is logical data independence. You are able to modify the relationship between two tables. You can change the primary key, foreign key. You are able to add something to it, any new constraint to it at any moment of time. Then it is called as logical data independence. In short, now, what is physical data independence? It is the ability to modify physical schema without disturbing other levels. It's called physical data independence. Then another definition is logical data independence. It is the ability to modify logical schema without disturbing other levels. It's called logical data independence. Have you understood, students?